They're starting out, ready to learn.
Reading and math, and taking turns.
Meeting new friends, and teachers too.
Try my best in all that I do.
My time has come, I'm on my way.
I'm really ready, this is the day.
I worked so hard to make it so.
Now I'm ready to go.
The future's looking good to me. I'm ready to go.
Doing my best, I'll make it through.
And you'll be watching my dreams come true.
I'll bring along all I have learned.
Now I'm ready to go.
Party. Everyone stand up and join us.
Come on, stand and sing with us.
Introducing Shawnee Mission School District Superintendent,
Dr. Jim Hinson, sir!
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The future is really looking good in the Shawnee Mission School District. Actually, the future is really looking great in the Shawnee Mission School District. Ladies and gentlemen, well over, thank you. Well over 300 elementary, middle, and high school students here this morning. Let's give them a great big round of applause, please. Thank you. As you know, getting Shawnee Mission students ready to go is really a team effort that includes enthusiastic students. And thank you, students. Involved parents, a dedicated faculty and staff, a devoted Board of Education, a committed community, willing to get involved and make a difference in the lives of students. A key partner in our education efforts is the Shawnee Mission Education Foundation. And as the students exit this morning, I want the Shawnee Mission Education Foundation Board to stand one more time this morning and be recognized for keeping in step and doing great things for the Shawnee Mission School District. Would the Shawnee Mission Education Foundation Board stand to be recognized one more time? Thank you. Yes, ma'am. I'd also like to recognize another group of volunteers, the Shawnee Mission School District Board of Education. They're here on the right where they stand this morning. Let's give our Board of Education a round of applause this morning, please. I'm excited to be with you this morning. I'm also humbled to be before you this morning because great things are going on in the Shawnee Mission School District. And a part of my charge today is to, in a brief period of time, give you an update of the great things that are going on in the district. We've been hard at work on our strategic plan and working on initiatives to transform education, not to improve education, ladies and gentlemen, but to transform education. In fact, we're in the midst of an important lifestyle change in the Shawnee Mission School District, and I will share more a little later in the presentation about a lifestyle change. But first, I'd like to bring you up to speed on some of the reasons we are proud to be SMSD.
Proud to be SMSD, sir!
I kind of like that. I could get used to that. So we're going to expect that in the office every day. Can you get you okay with that, Dr. Southwick? We're okay with that. The Shawnee Mission West, NJROTC. Thank them for joining us this morning as we highlight just a few of the reasons. Let's give them a round of applause. As we highlight just a few of the reasons why we are proud to be SMSD. By the way, make sure you keep the phrase proud to be SMSD in mind because we plan to use it to help us get the word out about the great things going on in the Shawnee Mission School District. Each time you use social media, many of you do on a regular basis, each time you use social media to share good news about the district, whether it's something you see here this morning or any time that you're in one of our buildings or facilities, make sure you hashtag proud to be SMSD, and let's see if we can really make that a trend. Some of the great things going on in the district. I'd like to start this morning by highlighting one of our key accomplishments this fall. You've heard a lot about school finance. Anybody not heard anything about school finance? You as our community told us there are some things you wanted to see happen. As a result, we eliminated fees for all-day kindergarten. We eliminated textbook fees at the elementary levels. And again, these changes were made because this is what you told us you wanted us to do when we made this possible. The move would not have been possible without the approval of the block grant funding, so we remained level funding for the Shawnee Mission School District. I'd like to thank our elected officials during a very difficult time for listening to our patrons, supporting education, and providing essential resources to the students of the Shawnee Mission School District. I'm also happy to announce that we've had our largest increase in student enrollment in the Shawnee Mission School District since 1992. At this breakfast a year ago, we discussed significant security upgrade needed at our buildings throughout the district with our then new Director of Emergency Services, John Douglas. We had started some, but we needed a lot more renovation and remodeling to make sure that we had all of the security upgrades we needed in the Shawnee Mission School District. We needed you to pass a $223 million bond issue this last January to make that happen, and you did. So thank you to our patrons for your overwhelming support this last January. And we're pleased to report that over the summer we've made great strides in bringing all of our buildings in line with the district's security standard. Some of the most significant changes will be seen in the entries at Shawnee Mission North and Shawnee Mission South. No longer will guests cross an interior hallway to enter the main office. When our security upgrades are all complete in the Shawnee Mission schools, we will have similar pinch points in each of our buildings in the district. In addition, to digital security systems, door access controls, bollards at exterior entrances, and signage at exterior entry points. Photo identification checks for all visitors will continue in the Shawnee Mission Schools. Shawnee Mission School District believes that the safety and security for our students and staff must be a priority for us in the day and time in which we live. We will remain vigilant as we move forward, including implementation of the District Emergency Operation Plan and a new way to track bullying through a bullying reporting app, and some of you may be aware. Another significant accomplishment this past year in the Shawnee Mission School District was the reintroduction of middle school sports. You can see some of that on the screen before you, but offering athletics in Shawnee Mission Middle Schools provided a healthy, inclusive environment in team sports that focuses on developing student athletes in preparation for extracurricular activities in high school. Last year, First National Bank, thank you, First National Bank, helped us kick off the great, extremely successful reintroduction of middle school sports. The response was overwhelming, with more than 1,300 middle school students taking part in after-school activities this last year as a result of the reintroduction of middle school sports. And again, this year, middle school boys and girls will be able to participate in cross-country, basketball, boys wrestling, girls volleyball. Stay tuned for more announcements about next year and what's going to happen. And after a successful first year, work is underway to expand the district's Project Lead the Way program. We call this Project Lead the Way Launch Program. This curriculum brings science, technology, engineering, and mathematics to elementary students. Launch was piloted this last year at Comanche, Oak Park, Carpenter, and Santa Fe Trail Elementary Schools. This summer, the district hosted a regional training where a significant number of additional teachers were trained to be launch instructors, allowing the program to expand to even more elementary schools in the Shawnee Mission School District. Our work to transform education in the Shawnee Mission School District has prompted some changes in the educational leadership team. From last year, you may remember Dr. Kenny Southwick, our deputy superintendent, Dr. Ed Strike, our chief academic officer, and John Douglas, that we just mentioned, our director of emergency services. Last year, we also added Bob Robinson, who oversees district facilities and transportation, and Drew Lane, who is the district's communication technology director. This year, we have added Dr. Rick Atha, who oversees finance and food and health services, Dr. Michelle Hubbard, who is in charge of elementary and secondary services, student services, and athletics, and Dr. Doug Sumner, who oversees human resources. A familiar face will also join me on the stage this morning, our leadership team, Dr. Christy Ziegler, who was in charge of STEM initiatives this last year, now oversees all curriculum instruction and assessment activities for the district. And again, you can see their pictures on the screen. When combined with meaningful instruction, technology in the classroom is powerful. Thanks to the district's digital learning initiative, teachers and students across the district are finding new ways to create, collaborate, communicate, and most importantly, learn. This fall, we have completed the final phase of the initiative of our digital learning initiative rollout, a significant goal, which means each student and teacher in grades K-12 now has a digital learning device. The final phase included students at 23 elementary schools. 23 elementary schools this school year receiving iPads. And based on educator feedback, a change was made at the middle school level. So this year at the middle school, we moved from the middle school students having iPads. They now have laptops in their hands. The laptops allow students a keyboard and additional hardware protection. Here's a quick look at some of the innovative things that are going on with the Digital Learning Initiative.
We deployed a very large number of devices across a wide variety of grade levels to a large number of people. We're talking over 30,000 devices across the district, and that is exciting. And students who feel like maybe they don't engage in what we might look at as a traditional classroom, they may be more willing to engage in a digital classroom.
One of the things that we found out was that, you know, now, it's just one more tool in the kids' toolkit and in my toolkit.
So it really helps. You can do more stuff. You don't have to worry about not having the technology that you need.
One of the things that I've noticed is that my kids are more apt to doing their homework, really enjoying engaging doing their homework. It's really helpful.
It was pretty cool because they take a basic lesson plan and they amplify it using the technology. I get to see an actual record of the kids working together and collaborating. And it definitely, according to Johnny, when he talks at home about it, it fosters more collaborative work.
Now that they have that device and they've got school where they can use school Wi-Fi and those types of things, it's really made it a lot easier for me to connect with them.
You see students engaging in their learning in a different way. You see teachers engaging in their profession in a different way. And you see positive results that come out of those two things. To me, that's what's really exciting when I look in those classrooms.
And ladies and gentlemen, you heard correctly. In just over a year, we have implemented over 30,000 technology devices in the Shawnee Mission School District. Special shout out to our technology team. They're doing an absolutely great, great job. Remember this morning, don't forget the hashtag as we go through the program, tweeting out the great things that are going on in the school district. Let's highlight a few of those things that are going on. And by the way, Laura Brogdon, our math teacher that we just saw there, she is the Secondary Kansas Teacher of the Year nominee from the Shawnee Mission School District. So, phenomenal young lady. Joining me now is Dr. Christy Ziegler. I mentioned Dr. Ziegler's name just a few minutes ago, but Dr. Ziegler is going to join me on the platform again. She's the district's assistant superintendent for curriculum, instruction, and assessment. A few things that are on her plate. She's going to share more about an essential component of our digital learning initiative, creating safe, responsible, and respectful digital citizens. Dr. Ziegler, thanks for joining us this morning.
Good Please morning. Share with us. Good morning. Thank you for the opportunity to let me talk about something that I'm a little bit passionate about, and that's the teaching and learning with technology in the Shawnee Mission School District. You know, we had an amazing opportunity, supported by our community and our Board of Education, to place technology in the hands of every single child in the Shawnee Mission learning community. And what an awesome opportunity that is, and what an amazing and powerful learning path we are on. We've just begun, so there's more to come. But with that increased technology comes a tremendous increase in responsibility, not only for us as educators, but also on our learners, our students, and I can speak from the heart as a parent of two children who love technology a little bit. It's an increase in my role as a parent at home. So I want to share with you some of the things that we are talking about and some tips and strategies that we are commonly communicating across our learning community to support our learners, to ensure that we do have positive interactions with technology while we're learning. Some of those tips include having an appropriate learning zone in the home so that our students know that there's an appropriate place where technology can be used and that we also are using it together and that our families have the opportunity to communicate and know how technology is being used to support learning for our children. We encourage our kids to share what apps they're learning and using in schools with their parents and families. We also encourage our families to sit down together and view websites and browsing histories. I know from my own experience with my children, I learn a lot about what their interests are by seeing what they are researching on the internet. I see a lot of Minecraft right now, which is a great construction tool. We also have some suggested resources that we use in the schools that we share out with our families, things like NetCetera and Common Sense Media, where families can go to learn more about appropriate apps and websites at the different age levels of our learners. And last, we have a common framework that we talk about with technology. It's responsible use. We have common expectations, whether you're an early childhood learner or you're a high school senior. It's quite simply this. We encourage our students to be safe, be respectful, be responsible when utilizing technology. So those are a few things that we have in place that we stress each year. We've just gone through the beginning of the year and we come right back to them to ensure that all of our interactions with technology can be as positive as possible.
Thank you, Dr. Ziegler, for sharing with us this morning about the Digital Learning Initiative. We're going to observe something today that's pretty awesome. How many of you remember being a sixth grader? I know for some of you this is quite a stretch, but remember being a sixth grader. Well, we have some sixth graders with us today. Mr. Farrell, if you would join us with your students today. Mr. Jonathan Farrell is one of our teachers in the Shawnee Mission School District. He's a teacher at Briarwood Elementary School. He is an absolutely awesome teacher. I mean, absolutely amazing. And Mr. Farrell's going to share with us today who might be with him and some of the things that are going on. So, Mr. Farrell, thank you for what you do. You're an amazing teacher. You change the lives of kids. We really value and appreciate who you are and what you do every day. You're doing some amazing things with kids with technology. Why don't you share with us today, please?
Thank you, Dr. Hinson. I have Celia and Barrett here with me today. And I just want to say that the Digital Learning Initiative has given the tools to our students to be creators and designers in our classroom. Behind me in a few minutes, there's going to be a video of our students using a green screen. And a green screen allows our students to create videos about what we're learning in our classroom. So you see Greer and Jackson there. We're talking about atoms in class right now. So instead of just learning about it a traditional way, the students are making movies to highlight their learning. A green screen uses the iPad and an app and just a green piece of fabric. It's similar to the technology the weatherman would use. And it allows our students to create and design movies that show what we're learning. So as we're studying ancient history in class and we're studying science, the students have a hands-on role of creating videos that we can share with each other, that we can share with their parents, and we can share with the world.
Thank you, Mr. Farrell. You have some young people with us today. And so it's great to have you with us here this morning. And so I just have a couple questions for you before you show us what you have here today. Are you nervous?
A little.
A little? A little. So we're all going to get along really well this morning. So that works out great. And so you're students at Briarwood Elementary School. Mm-hmm. You've gone through a transition from last May until now because we're rebuilding Briarwood Elementary School, closed down the building. They're at the Broadmoor facility, so you've changed buildings. You're handling that extremely well. We're so very proud of you. So, Mr. Farrell, what do we have today? Share with us, please.
We're going to show you two things today. The first thing that Celia's going to show you is the iPad microscope, and then Barrett's going to dive in and show you how we use our 3D printer as an engineering tool in the classroom. So, Celia, do you want to show them how the microscope works?
Yeah, this is our wireless portable microscope that we use sometimes in class. And these are cool because you can just connect them to the same Wi-Fi as your iPad, and then they're a lot easier to carry around than the other older, bigger microscopes. So this is steel wool, and this is something that we'll focus on later in the year when we're studying chemical reactions. So if I focus the microscope on the steel wool, you can see what we wouldn't be able to see without a microscope, details that we wouldn't be able to see. And then also, Dr. Henson's tie today.
Well. Dr. Hinson, I sure hope that that tie's clean.
I don't know. June, is this tie clean? Okay, it's clean. Thank you.
As a teacher, what I love about these microscopes is it allows the students to get up and move around. We have the Broadmoor Urban Farm in our backyard over while we're over at the Broadmoor building, and the students can take these microscopes outside and explore their surroundings. It's a great learning tool, and you can see wonderful ties.
Wonderful clean ties. Great, thank you.
And Barrett's going to dive in and talk a little bit about how our 3D printer works and how we use it in our classroom.
Last year, Mr. Farrell got a 3D printer in his sixth grade class, and we can use it to print anything that we need around our houses or anything that may have broken or anything like that. And this is a terracotta soldier, and we're going to soon be studying about them in social studies. And this is a vase that he made using an app called Print Shop, and you can make a vase like this, maybe a bracelet, a ring, or some sort of medallion.
What we love about the 3D printer, students have always had creative ideas and inventions, but they're usually in their head, they're kind of theoretical. But this printer prints them out in real life, in plastic. Do you want to talk a little bit about how the printer works, Barrett?
Basically, there is a filament that feeds through the printer, and it heats it up so it melts, and then it comes out of the bottom, and it very slowly forms a pattern on whatever you're creating. So this probably would have taken probably 2 hours to create layer by layer.
And it's just a great tool for making the students' ideas and inventions come to life.
Ladies and gentlemen, sixth graders. I don't think we had this technology when most of us were in sixth grade. And so outstanding students demonstrating today. So let me ask you two questions. One, do you have family members here today?
Yeah, my mom and dad.
Would you introduce them, please?
Yeah, Carrie Condon and Michael Condon.
Would you stand and be recognized this morning? Congratulations on having a wonderful, wonderful daughter. My other question for you is, what do you want to be when you're out of school and you're an adult?
An actress.
An actress. I think you have a great start. What about you? You have family here today?
Yes, I do. My mom, my dad, my grandma, my other grandma, and my grandpa.
And so, would you introduce them by name and they can be stand? They can stand to be recognized?
Sarah Brookfield, Aaron McKee, Shannon McKee, Barbara McKee, and Timothy McKee.
Now, as a sixth grader on the stage this morning, when you're accustomed to saying mom, dad, grandpa, grandma, and you have to think about names, it's a little more difficult. And so when you're out of school, you're an adult, you want to be what in life?
An engineer.
An engineer. Off to a great start as well. Ladies and gentlemen, two of our best and brightest sixth graders. Let's give them a round of applause. Mr. Farrell, thank you. Thank you, Dr. Ziegler. How many of you want to go back and be a sixth grader again? Another great way of using technology is found at Broken Arrow Elementary School, where iPads are adding a whole new dimension to the school's Trailblazer After School Club. Students use the devices to create videos that they share with school to promote upcoming events and things that other students in the school need to know. Today, they wanted to share with us a public service announcement they created on how to be a good digital citizen.
We're students from Trailblazer Academy at Broken Arrow Elementary, and we're going to tell you 8 things about
digital citizenship.
Number 1, do not talk to strangers online.
Number 2, no bullying online, so be nice.
Number 3, do not become obsessed with games.
Number 4, don't spend all day on your device. Go outside and play.
Number 5,
protect your digital reputation.
Because a lot of what you do is public and permanent, so watch out.
Protect your personal information, or else.
Report cyberbullying to an adult.
Keep your iPad in your backpack or hug it like a baby while walking in the halls.
Now you know the top 8 things that will help keep your iPad out of trouble.
Remember to be a good digital citizen.
Members of the Broken Arrows After School Club are here this morning along with their principal, Mike Brewer. Mr. Brewer and the students from Broken Arrow Elementary School, would you stand to be recognized this morning, please? Thank you very much. And as you can see, ladies and gentlemen, digital citizenship, the responsible use of technology, is a very significant and very important issue for us that we will continue to stress in the Shawnee Mission School District. Community support is really making a difference in so many different things that we do, and right now a very visible difference in the Shawnee Mission School District. Again, thanks to your overwhelming support of the $223 million bond issue, it's been a busy summer of construction throughout the school district. It continues to be a busy time of construction. We already showed you some of the safety and security changes going on in the district. High schools also received technology upgrades to improve speed, capacity, security, and Wi-Fi accessibility. All of these improvements help to support our digital learning initiative and certainly learning in the Shawnee Mission School District. And again, thanks to you, we spent the summer on a significant number of important facility reinvestment and major maintenance projects throughout the school district. These projects included roof work at 6 schools, full-service kitchen installations at Corinth, John Deemer, and Westwood View Elementary Schools, as well as a remodel of Shawnee Mission's East Cafeteria. We also put in new synthetic turf fields at Shawnee Mission East, Shawnee Mission North, and we are partnering with the City of Lenexa, working currently to develop something that you may have heard a little bit about. In addition, the bond funding has allowed the district to begin the process of building one elementary facility in each of our 5 high school attendance areas. Doing this will bring these buildings up to date to support current educational needs and programs and complete what you ask us to do in the Shawnee Mission School District. Joining me now to talk a little more about so much going on with remodeling, renovation, construction, Dr. Kenny Southwick, our Deputy Superintendent. Dr. Southwick, thanks for being here this morning. We appreciate it immensely. Dr. Southwick oversees everything that I just talked about and some more that we're going to share this morning. So let's give him a round of applause, please. Dr. Kenny Southwick.
Good morning.
Dr. Southwick, you've been just a little busy over the summer and started the school year. Talk to us a little bit about what's going on.
Well, it's been awesome. You've heard that word a lot, but it's an authentic word in the Shawnee Mission School District. Just some great things going on right now. As you know, that construction time that we have in the summer, and you've mentioned a lot of those projects, that's only about 2 months. So we've ran real fast over the last couple of months to get some projects underway. But I want to remind you of a challenge that you gave us right after the bond issue, and that was I want to see 4 elementary schools out of the ground by Christmas. And I said, oh boy. But we've taken that challenge on with our partners, and we're happy to say that we move forward with the design. We're having those plans approved, and we'll be under construction very quickly. So it's a very exciting time for us.
And we've had some groundbreaking ceremonies already. Would you explain those?
We had a great groundbreaking at Trailwood, Greg Lawrence and his staff, and we had some parents there, the media were there. We had a gorgeous day. What's great about that school is that every single day our students will be able to look out. They'll be able to see how that building will be constructed. And there's a lot of lessons to be learned around relevance as that building goes up. Construction obviously is math. We have an opportunity to look at science and literature along the way. So it'll be a very relevant activity over the next 18 months or so for our students.
We had a beautiful day for the groundbreaking at Trailwood. Crestview?
Not so good. Had a little bit of rain that day, a little bit of thunder. I think we made a wise administrative decision to not take 300 kids out and enjoy that day. But we are groundbreaking on Monday, the 14th. And we hope to maybe see some of the people that are here today shovel a little bit of dirt for us as we begin to look at that new school as well.
We have some other schools that are in the planning stage right now at the elementary level. So let's talk about those, please.
Yeah, we do. Briarwood, obviously, is also a rebuild. I want to mention that the Crestview students and staff, as well as Briarwood students and staff, have moved. And I'll go a shout out to them because their staff and students, administration, and parents have just been awesome as they've moved from one building to another to continue their education. So in both of those sites, we'll tear those buildings down. The demolition starts hopefully within the next week or so, and we'll be building back new state-of-the-art schools, rich in technology, will help us meet the educational mission for those kids in that building, as well as you've mentioned the safety around those schools. So refreshing those neighborhoods.
And I think that's an important thing for us to remember. Over the course of the last couple of months, we moved 2 elementary schools. We closed the building down, moved everything out that we could move. And we had faculty, staff, parents, students, so many people that made it possible for those schools to close down at the end of May and start in August in an entirely different building. And so we really appreciate the hard work of so many different people. Ryan Benninghoven in the Northwest area, what's going on there?
Yes, that building is a little bit behind the others. I think we'll be breaking ground somewhere around Christmas, maybe have a Christmas tree and we'll break a little ice to do that. But we did look for an alternative site for that building for several months. We're unable to do that. So that building also will be raised on site, and those students as well will have an opportunity to see that building go up right there on their campus. So as you know, it's right next door to Northwest High School. So we hope there's a great opportunity for a lot of students to see that process go on. We do have one other school. We had made commitment to bond issue that each one of the new of the high schools feeder patterns would have a new elementary school. We're looking at the energy on the west side of the district, and we're trying to calculate where's the best location for that new elementary school. So we hope to have some announcements in the near future.
And ladies and gentlemen, that's an important fact to remember. We're up this year, again, more students than we've been since 1992. Most of the expansion, the development going on within the boundaries of the Shawnee Mission School District is just really getting started. So under construction or in the planning process, there are well over 7,000 new doorways inside of the Shawnee Mission School District. So our increase in enrollment's really small in comparison to what we think it's going to be over the next several years. So we're looking at not a replacement, but an additional elementary school in the Shawnee Mission School District, planning for the future. So that's certainly an exciting time for us. Dr. Southwick, all of these activities going on almost simultaneously, it wouldn't happen without the partnerships that we have. So much progress has taken place over the summer. It's going to continue to take place. But we'd like to give a special thanks to this morning to a strong support we've received from some of our partners in these projects, and they're here this morning. So when I call your name, if you would stand to be recognized, J.E. Dunn Construction, you're here, Hollis and Miller, ACI Bolin Architects, you're under tight time frames as well. So would you stand to be recognized? We appreciate the partnerships with you this morning as well.
And the message to all of you, right after breakfast, back to work.
That's a very clear message. In addition to all of those bond-funded projects, we're working on some other projects as well. And you can see some of those on the screen. We call these the non-bond-funded or the capital outlay projects. So we're in the process of rebuilding Shawnee Elementary School. The goal is to move in this spring to Shawnee, and we're on target there, and also construction of our new Center for Academic Achievement. That construction is also underway. And so just a couple of weeks ago, we held the groundbreaking ceremony there at the former Antioch Middle School site. Some of you might remember it under even a different name. But the center is going to allow us to consolidate our administrative operations for improved efficiency. It will also become the home to several of our signature programs in the district. It's going to include a new commercial kitchen and bistro for the culinary arts program, teaching spaces for Project Lead the Way, medical health science programs, and new laboratories for our biotechnology program. So I want to pause there because one of the things that you said in the community is we want a central location to really highlight the signature programs in the district. This is the Center for Academic Achievement, and at the same time, we're taking multiple facilities that are being used for administrative purposes down to one to improve efficiency in that regard as well. So ladies and gentlemen, efficiency, just from an administrative standpoint, we're taking over 500,000 square feet to a little over 70,000 square feet for administrative space. We are also going to save approximately $2 million annually in administrative costs for efficiency by going to one site so we can better use the resources you've entrusted us with to impact the lives of students. So, Dr. Southwick, you're very busy. We appreciate everything you're doing. By the way, as soon as breakfast is over, you better get back to work as well. So thank you, Dr. Southwick. Let's give him a round of applause, please. Speaking of students and a signature program, this morning we have outstanding students in the biotechnology program. They're here to talk about their medical research. You're going to hear a lot more about medical research conducted by our students in the Shawnee Mission School District over the next several months. They're going to show us what we have, the program that we have now in the Shawnee Mission School District, the caliber of students that we have. And ladies and gentlemen, this is absolutely gonna knock your socks off. I'm so excited about what our students that you're gonna see this morning are doing in the Shawnee Mission School District. Lexi Allen, Aaron Smith are with us this morning. They're gonna join us on the stage.
Biotechnology means a lot of different things to a lot of people, but basically it's applying technology to solve problems that occur in living systems or living organisms.
What first got me interested in biotech was just the hands-on experience that you gain here. In normal science classrooms, it's great that we get to learn so much specifically from the textbook, but here you can take all that knowledge, advancing skills needed for research, being able to analyze things better, being able to be a better problem solver.
I learned so much more than I would have taken any other program. So what I have here in the lab is what I could use at West. I can run gels, I could do PCR here. So I actually get to help a grad student working on her PhD with Western blots, and I actually know more about it thanks to the biotechnology program.
You're going to get out of it as much as you put in. So know that it's going to take effort, and again, your level of commitment, your level of effort is up to you.
but you'll get out tenfold what you put in.
You'll get out tenfold what you put in. That's a powerful statement. Ladies, introduce yourself, and if you have family members here this morning, introduce them as well, please.
Absolutely. I'm Lexi Allen. I am a senior at Shawnee Mission West High School, and I have multiple guests here with me today. Shawnee Mission has been a great fan of mine, so there's a couple of Board of Education members here today that are big fans of mine, but I specifically wanted to talk about Ms. Cindy Neely, who is my counselor, and I also have my principal here, and Mr. Lowe, and then I have Jennifer Silverstein, who is my Girl Scout leader. But most importantly, last but not least, my wonderful mother. I would not be able to do anything I do without her. So Jennifer Allen, if I could have those people please stand up just so you guys can be recognized.
And then, hi, my name's Aaron Smith. I'm a sophomore at Shawnee Mission West. And I also had the same like school administrators and stuff, but I also have Joanne Smith, who's my mom, and then Jolynn Smith, who's my sister.
Would you stand and be recognized this morning? Thank you for being here. Ladies, tell us what having strong business partnerships and research partnerships really means to the research that you've been doing at Shawnee Mission West.
Absolutely. So the Shawnee Mission West Biotechnology Program has multiple business partners, and I think that they, obviously the funding helps put on our research laboratory, but the great thing about all of our partners is that normally each individual student has a connection with one partnership. Mine happens to be UMKC and Dr. Leonard Dobbins, which is the research lab that I work at. But normally a student will make this strong connection with partnerships, and then ultimately they can become their mentor or guide them throughout their career. So basically the entire biotechnology program is benefited by it and each individual student.
Yeah, and I think one thing that people might not notice or even realize is that you don't wake up one day knowing exactly what Spodoptera frugiperda ovarian tissue cells are.
Wait a minute, did everybody get that? Okay.
You also don't wake up knowing how to pronounce it. But you have these amazing partnerships and these amazing mentors that teach you so much. And like Lexi said, we usually all are kind of unofficially paired up with one. And so it kind of creates a cycle of perpetual understanding and knowledge, because they teach you one thing, and then you go on to teach another person that same thing, and it just continues on and on. So it's really just a cycle of goodness.
Okay, ladies, this kind of makes me a little nervous, because your level of research being conducted at Shawnee Mission West is absolutely phenomenal.
Thank you.
I mean, it seriously, ladies and gentlemen, it brings chills up and down my spine to think about the research these young ladies are doing daily, one of the high schools in the Shawnee Mission School District. So talk to us about your research, please.
Absolutely. So the scientific title of my research is The Roles of Tribbles in Tumor Formation in Drosophila melanogaster. But to put it into basic terms, patients with diabetes are more predisposed to cancer, but no one understands why. And so my hypothesis is that maybe insulin is the link between the two diseases. So I decided that I was going to start studying a newly discovered gene called tribbles. Any of you Star Trek fans out there? That's what it's named after, the tribbles. And tribbles actually has the ability to interact with other genes in the insulin signaling pathway. But the thing that's really interesting about this gene is that we know where it's located, but we have no idea what this gene does. And so I am studying how it interacts with other genes to ultimately see how it affects diabetes patients being predisposed to cancer. And I actually have my research that supports that tribbles actually acts as an oncogene and ultimately could be the reason why diabetic patients are predisposed to cancer. And so basically what I want to do is I want to continue on this research, and hopefully we can put a treatment together so that we can manipulate this gene so that no longer diabetic patients will also have cancer disease.
Everybody get that? Okay. Aaron, why don't you share with us, please?
So the title of my project was The Effects of Theobroma Cacao on the Cell Cycle, an ability to induce apoptosis in Spodoptera frugiperda ovarian tissue cells. And so essentially what this was doing is that per year, more than 7 million people die due to cancer. And just to kind of put that into perspective, I did some calculations. And during the time period that we'll be at this breakfast this morning, a little over 200 people will die due to cancer. And so essentially why this is that current cancer treatment options such as chemotherapy, radiation, and other drugs are merely inefficient and ineffective. They kill healthy tissues and cells along with cancerous tissues and cells. So in order to more efficiently and more effectively treat cancer and to actually treat just the cancer, we need to find something that can induce apoptosis, which is programmed cell death in cancerous cells. And so the substance that I decided to test was cocoa powder. And this is from a plant that is kind of emerging in importance. And essentially what I found is that I was originally trying to see if it could act, if it could induce apoptosis and be a potential treatment method. But while doing my research, I found out that there's actually a substance in cocoa powder that actually exacerbated the cancer growth and even may go as far as causing cancer. So that was kind of a twist in the data.
Absolutely amazing, ladies. And we need to say congratulations to you because these ladies were invited to compete in the Intel International Science and Engineering Fair. So my understanding is there were 7,000 high school students. Is that right? That started from around
7 million.
7 million in the world. Little difference, 7,000, 7 million. Thank you. I appreciate that very much. And then it was narrowed down to 1,700 that actually attended this international competition from around the world. And so out of all of those competitors, Lexi, yours was selected as the grand prize winner out of all of that competition.
Thank you. I did take first place. I did take first place in animal science, my category. And the picture that was just on the screen before was actually the picture of when I just found out I took first place, which puts me among the top 20 best high school researchers in the world.
Congratulations. And Erin, you were just published in a national journal as well for research. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, so one of the big takeaways from the Intel International Science and Engineering Fair this past year was that they just started that along with the fair, they want to start a journal. Specifically, it's an international science journal for high school students. And so about 3 months ago, I submitted my paper to be reviewed. They had professors and other researchers review the papers and then select the ones. And I found out like 2 days ago that I was one of the papers selected for the inaugural edition of this magazine.
So ladies, I'm gonna really put you on the spot. So obviously you're brilliant. I mean, absolutely brilliant. I'm going to think about how to pronounce that for a long time, but it's not going to happen. So what's the one thing, if you could accomplish one thing in life to benefit all humankind, what's that one thing you would love to accomplish in your lifetime?
That's easy. I want to be the best surgeon in the world.
Did you get that? Erin?
Oh, that's not so easy. I guess it would probably be just to expose human potential to everyone that I come in contact with and help them like be my best self and help them be their best self too.
Ladies and gentlemen, I firmly believe these ladies are going to help change the world in which we live. A senior and a sophomore at Shawnee Mission West High School, Shawnee Mission School District. Let's give them a great big round of applause. Thanks, ladies. Thank you very much. I told you that'd give you goosebumps. I'm gonna tell you one more time, in the Shawnee Mission School District, we're just starting to tap the potential of this type of research that can occur with students and at a much younger age. So stay tuned for those announcements over the next several months. The success of our biotechnology program is dependent upon partnerships. Many of the initiatives going on in the district wouldn't happen without you, our community. And as Lexi and Aaron told you, their program relies on business partners and scientists willing to be research mentors. As it is with many of our biggest success stories in the district, the key components to making the difference for each student is you, a committed community willing to get involved in changing and improving the quality of life for our students. We're going to switch gears a little bit. You may have heard about another exciting partnership starting this fall in the Shawnee Mission School District. Now, this is really going to get some of you wishing, gosh, could I really go back to PE class in school? The Midwest section of the PGA's Starting New at Golf in School program, or SNAG, will be a part of the Shawnee Mission School District physical education curriculum.
SNAG is Starting New at Golf. It's really the best entry-level program for teaching the game I've ever seen. It introduces all the fundamentals that you hope your future golfers will embody. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Our program is about golf professionals and local businesses giving back to the community. It's about $24,000 that we've invested in the Shawnee Mission School District, and it's cost the school system $0.
We want the teachers to leave this 3-hour workshop and be able to teach this program tomorrow.
PE teachers are such a huge part of this program. Statistics have shown that if a kid is taught a sport early in life, that they are more likely to come back to it later.
Some kids never been introduced to golf, and this might be their ticket to college to get a scholarship. So just introducing them to all different kinds of things, once they get the basics down and the fundamentals down, it was really fun for all of us out here, so I know the kids are gonna enjoy it.
You know, a lifetime sport's something you can do throughout your lifetime, whether it's tennis or swimming or golf. You know, I've done archery, I've done bowling. I'd like to introduce things that motivate the kids that they can learn how to do and carry throughout a lifetime.
Golf is a gift. Golf encompasses all the values that we hope our children will have. Kids will get excited about golf and play it for the rest of their lives because it is a sport you can play from the time you're 5 years old to the time you're 95 years old.
You know, I love those partnerships. They contributed all the money and the resource, and it didn't cost the district anything. Those are great partnerships, but lifetime sports and activities. And so, Jeff, you saw in the video, Tom, other members of the Midwest PGA board are here this morning. Would you stand and be recognized this morning? We appreciate your partnership with SNAG and the Shawnee Mission School District. So wherever you are, would you stand and be recognized this morning? They're over here. Thank you, gentlemen. We appreciate that very much. By the way, if any of you need any private golf lessons, you might look them up afterward. After watching a few of you golf before, some of you need to look them up afterward. Trust me. Early childhood education is critical for many students to have the right start in life. If we truly want to make a difference in the life of each child in the district and create an educational system where all means all, it must start before some students even enter kindergarten. Early childhood education is essential for future student success. That is the reasoning behind our Jumpstart program. It brings children to school to summer before they enter kindergarten to learn the school routine so they are ready to hit the ground running, so to speak, when school starts. We are so pleased that the Shawnee Mission Education Foundation agrees with this philosophy that all means all, and thanks to their support of the foundation, our Jumpstart program continues to grow and thrive, making a difference for more and more students each year.
Guess what? We are going to play the I Spy game.
Well, Jumpstart's a program that our superintendent piloted last year in 3 schools. It's 15 days long, and it allows incoming kindergarten students to get a Jumpstart with some curriculum and social skills building.
What sound does M make again?
They're working on basic letter sounds. They're also working on recognizing numbers. Also the basics of sitting in the chair, learning directions, kind of how the school works.
All right, I have a few left, but but if you know what this is, are you gonna yell it out?
No.
They learned the routines, they got established in the classroom. They also were able to have a chance to start developing that relationship, that emotional connection to teachers. The kids are ecstatic. They're so excited to come into school. They're all smiles when they walk in the door. What we found was those kids from that classroom were all of a sudden leaders. They were the class role models. They were the peer models that everybody else was looking to.
When I'm thinking of JumpStart, I'm thinking it's just a wonderful gift. What we're hopeful, and I believe what they saw in the three schools from last year, is that it really built their confidence up. And that's what JumpStart's about, is that giving them a feel of success starting kindergarten. And we all want our children to be successful.
Thanks, and remember to post the hashtag SMSD. We're hoping we can really make it trend. Now I'd like to focus a little bit on where education is going. I talked a little bit about a lifestyle change. We talk about a fixed mindset and a growth mindset. Our priority, again, is to make sure that all means all in the Shawnee Mission School District. We refuse to be defined by circumstance. We refuse to give you any excuse of what we can't do for our children. We're committed to ensuring that all of our students are prepared for their life ahead. Our challenge is to make sure the education we are providing students includes both rigor and relevance coupled with relationships. Think about this question. Is what we're doing currently in public education relevant? As you think about this question, again, keep in mind that today's kindergarten students represent the class of 2028. Ladies and gentlemen, a part of our question, what will the world look like in 2028, and what skills do our students need to be successful in the world in which we live? We've been asking ourselves challenging questions in relation to how do we prepare our students for the future. We've been working with Dr. Willard Daggett in the International Center for Leadership and Education. Today's students are some of the best educated in the history of our country. But we're discovering that our type of education maybe does not necessarily best prepare our students for future success. Think about that. Traditional education with a focus on academic achievement above all has created a gap between the speed at which society is moving and the speed at which public education is improving. We believe the best way to close the gap or even reverse it is to adapt what Dr. Daggett calls that growth mindset, where technology is used to transform education by developing ways to infuse academics and other disciplines such as art, music, physical education, and career education. I didn't say college and career, I said career education. To develop and drive the perseverance that pushes students beyond what they believe they could accomplish and truly make a difference in doing what they didn't dream possible for themselves initially. That continued academic success is what we're focusing on in the Shawnee Mission School District. These transformative ideas will really bring change and improvement to what we're doing in the Shawnee Mission School District to empower students to be the leaders of their own learning. For us in Shawnee Mission to continue the tradition of excellence, we must be on the mindset of growth to accomplish what we need to accomplish with our students, and we need your help. I mentioned that we're undergoing a lifestyle change in the district. If we're to continue to be relevant and continue to have rigor, we must be able to see some things differently than maybe we've seen them in the past, and we can only do that with your help. Together, we can make a difference in the lives of our students. Each student that walks through our doors is so very important. Remember these key principles. All means all. It's a growth mindset versus a fixed mindset. We refuse to be defined by any circumstance, and we refuse to offer any excuse of what we can't do for the children of the Shawnee Mission School District. One student at a time in the Shawnee Mission School District.
When I grow up, I want to be a scientist.
I would like to be a doctor.
I want to be a police officer.
I will be a pirate.
Big.
policeman.
Spider-Man.
A rock star.
I want to be a nurse.
I would like to be a doctor.
Do you make a difference?
Will you make a difference?
Will you make a difference?
Will you make a difference?
Make a difference.
Make a difference.
Make a difference.
Will you make a difference?
Thanks, and once again, please remember to use this hashtag when you post to social media. The question that our students, children, ask us is, will you make a difference? The task that we have in the Shawnee Mission School District of improving the quality of what we do through the growth mindset, not the fixed mindset of what we have always known, is a challenge for us. We will meet that challenge regardless of anything that happens anywhere else, because we will be the best. Our motto this year is not to be the best we can be. It's simply to be the best. You might ask why. Because the children you send to us every day, that's what they deserve. If the Shawnee Mission School District isn't providing the best for your children, we're not meeting the needs of your children. Great things are really going on in the school district. We are really in a position to say all means all, to make a difference in the life of each and every student in our district. But to transform education in this way, we need people to get involved in our schools and our classrooms. Check out a video in relation to the MVP volunteer program this morning.
I'm involved in what's called the Lunch Buddy program. So it's, in my mind, it's a mentorship program in which I've sort of adopted the attitude of being a trusted guide for Chris. He's opened up to me a lot more, and that of course makes things a lot more useful to me in terms of knowing what maybe I need to concentrate on.
I like to talk about what I'm doing, and he talks about what he's doing, and it's a good flow of information between both of us, which works out, I would say, perfectly. I value this relationship more than a lot of other relationships that I keep here, and I hope that we can keep this going until I graduate from high school.
There's times where I think I'm learning more from Chris than Chris is learning from me.
I've changed, I've set my goals, I've aspired for bigger things in the future. He's helped me through that, and without his help, I wouldn't know what I'd be doing in, 15 years or so.
Ron and Chris are with us this morning. Ron and Chris, would you stand to be recognized? They're right over here. Thank you very, very much. It's a very exciting time to be a part of the Shawnee Mission School District. This morning, we've shown you a little bit where we've been, talked a little bit about where we're going. We will continue to emphasize that all means all and that we're going to be the best. If our students are truly to excel, it's really up to each of us to make a difference in the lives of each student, ladies and gentlemen, in the Shawnee Mission School District. I'm going to say this one more time before the choir sings. We have a great team in the district. I couldn't be any more proud of our teachers, of our administrators. Seriously, they're doing a fabulous job changing the lives of kids. But to be the very best, we need you. We need your partnership. We need your commitment, your dedication. You've been phenomenal. We need your continued support to be the very best, because each student in the Shawnee Mission School District, that's what they deserve.
For those who inspire us today, who
always lend a helping hand to help show us the way.
This song is for those who help our students through the tough times in their lives, so that we say thank you.
You have made a difference. You have changed our hearts. You have changed the world, one child at a time. You have always been there in everything I do. I hope that you're as proud of me as I am proud of you.
This song is for those who taught us right from wrong, who taught us much more than their craft to help our minds grow strong.
This song is for those who guide us through and through, so that we can make a life for that we say thank you.
You have made a difference, you have shaped our lives. You have changed the world, one child at a time. You have always been there in everything I do. I hope that you're as proud of me as I am proud of you.
As I look ahead in life into the path within my reach, I hope I can change a life because of those who teach.
I can make a difference, all I do.
I am proud of you.
Wasn't that awesome? Ladies and gentlemen, students of the Shawnee Mission School District, over 330 of them today. That's why we're all here. And you really make a difference. Before you leave today, don't forget the envelopes that are on the table. That challenge was presented to you as we started today. We're in a great, great place in the Shawnee Mission School District. There's a lot going on. We're a little busy. That's what our kids deserve. That's what our kids deserve. Thank you for your support. Thank you for your commitment. Everything you do for being here this morning. We couldn't do it without you. Have a wonderful, wonderful day. Thank you very much.